What's up, y'all? Flip here, EUC Chronicles, back with another goodie. And today we are out for a long distance ride. As you saw in the title, we went on a 73-mile ride. Some of the guys have a few more miles on because they actually rode to the meetup spot. I drove my truck there, so I didn't get the extra couple of miles, but 72 miles we clocked that day on this new bike trail that one of our guys, Darren, put us up onto. And that's kind of the reason why I went out. I was having a horrible week last week. Unfortunately, a really long time friend of mine of 30 years passed in a tragic car accident. So all of us who were connected to him have been dealing with that as the best we could. And I kind of been just kind of like moping in the house and not doing anything. And when I saw that the guys were going to go this group ride and it was like a completely different, you know, trail that we've never been on before, I was like, you know what? I need to get out the house. Let me, you know, get myself together and throw some gear on and go. And I'm so glad that I did. I absolutely needed that ride. I needed that energy. I needed to be re-energized. And you know, in all that's happened, it was definitely necessary and needed. So I like to thank the guys for that. I didn't tell them what I was going through. I'm always like that. My world could be falling apart and I would still show up with a smile on my face and nobody would be none the wiser. You know, I didn't want to bring that energy to the group and I didn't want everybody kind of feeling sorry for me. So I just showed up and, you know, acted like everything was okay. But, you know, by the time the ride was over, you know, I felt much better. And, you know, like I said, I just want to thank you guys for that. So we went on this ride and, Man, did I learn a lot going on a ride this long. I've never been on a ride this long or gone that fast before. I'm now officially in the 40s and up club, as you can see on the EUC World app that I posted a little while ago. But, you know, the speed is doesn't really matter. My book bag accessories will drastically change after being on a ride like this. No one said in the group chat that we're going to go for such a long ride. We just said we're going to go for a ride, you know. But normally I bring things in my book bag to make sure I'm prepared for stuff like this. But this day definitely caught me off guard. I didn't bring a phone charger. You know, I had the charger for my wheel, thank God, because I needed it. Matter of fact, everybody needed it. Even Echo with the Master Pro, he even plugged his Master Pro in when we made it to the halfway point. So that's kind of the thing that I was kind of looking at. You know, most of the wheels are 3,600 watt hours and up for the most part. And everybody had to charge. Now, me riding my EXN, which is 2,700 watt hour, I was low. By the time we got back towards the end of the trail, and we also had to just cancel the rest of the trip, we were like maybe 7 miles away from where we started, and it got so cold out. And by the time we made it back, and I'll explain why, as soon as we got to the gas station, everybody was just like start calling their significant others and just getting rides back because it was just way too cold. A lot of us was running on a very low battery. I was at 15%, so I knew the chances of me making it back were slim. You know, I didn't mind. I would have stuck around and charged my wheel and then rolled back, but like I said, it was just uncomfortably cold at this point. So, you know, we all called it quits. So it would have been an 80 mile ride if we didn't call it quits, you know. But I realized that my seat, as comfortable as it is for short, you know, rides or short sitting duration, for as long as the ride as we did on the way back, I pretty much rode seated the entire time. And man, my buns were sore. You know, the seat held up. It holds great. It's just that for sitting for that amount of time, it definitely takes a toll. So I'm gonna have to do some readjusting later on down the line. I don't think we're going to be going for these extended rides every single trip. Although this was incredibly fun, we got to see some stuff. This was all in all just a great ride. It's just that it was very taxing on everybody. Like, the bottoms of my feet are still like sore and red from just like standing on the tips of my feet, you know, from like, you know, the friction of your sneaker. And it is now 3 days later since that ride, and I'm still feeling the effects of that. So definitely gonna be changing the contents of my book bag, you know, as far as, you know, wires. I brought my pump, thank God. I have a tubeless tire, so I wasn't really worried about flats. But, you know, if I didn't have a tubeless tire, I would definitely bring a tire change kit, as well as some tools that I can get into my wheel, God forbid, if something happened on a trip like that. Not saying that I would want to be on the side of the road fixing my wheel, but it is definitely something that I, after this trip, I'm like, you know what? Because I'm usually an Inspector Gadget guy, you know, I'm the MacGyver guy, you know, always have something for every situation. But for this trip, I was completely unprepared. And I'm just like, you know what? From now on, I never will be unprepared. No matter what happens, no matter where we go, I'm going to have everything I need, you know, in that backpack. I actually ordered a bigger backpack now for that for that very reason. But yeah, the guys, everybody had to charge. And what happened was, you know, when I got down to about 57%, and we were still a good ways out, you know, we were like, you know, well, Echo was more so like, yeah, Echo's the one with the Master Pro, just so you know who I'm referring to. He was like, yo, you know, we should just turn around. And Darren, who kind of organized this specific trip, and Darren rides the Commander, he said, hey, my family, my mom and dad have a camp near here, you know, so just a few miles up the road, we can go there and charge and whatnot. And, you know, in our heads, we're all thinking, you know, it's just like this little, you know, spot in the woods camp thing, you know. So we all agreed, we all rode up there, and man, yo, this was, when you see it, you'll see it in the footage in a little bit. It's coming up towards the end. This was not a camp. This was like their house. You're right by the lake. It was great. We had a shade. We were fishing. We were canoeing. Like, we had an adventure hanging out there just waiting for the wheels to charge. So that also kind of messed things up, because we were having so much fun there, we spent so much time there, that by the time we started riding back, that's when the sun started going down, and that's when the cold really started to catch us. Because when we were there, it was times where it was like almost too hot sitting out there in the sun. But all in all, it was a great time. I'm so glad I went, because like, it was just like some random things, like, yeah, my family has a camp, and we're just like, oh yeah, cool. And we get there, and we're just like, dude, like, we want to go up here every trip now, you know. So that was definitely fun. I've with the seated rider thing, you know, this is probably the first time I rode this long seated as well, and I got to get very comfortable with it. Now obviously, you know, people who've been riding seated for years or so, they are way more skilled, but I'm starting to see why seated riding is so much fun, and how you can have just as much fun seated as you can standing. Which, you know, I looked at seated riding as just a necessity, something you need to do to, you know, relax your legs and, you know, give yourself a rest. And that is not necessarily true, because, you know, we were standing and riding so long, there were points when I went from seated to a standing position and my calves were burning. I mean, burning. And I had to like sit back down again. So there was times where I was just forced to ride seated because standing was just too painful. And being able to ride seated, I started carving while I was seated and whatnot. I'm like, yo, I've never carved while seated, but like, that's how comfortable I got with the seated ride. And I really, really started to enjoy it. You know what I mean? Like, I really, like, all right, it kind of clicked, like, oh, this is not just for a necessity. This is just another way of comfortably riding, and also getting a little more out of your EEC, because there's not as much wind resistance. So you could get, squeeze a few more miles out of those batteries by doing that. Speaking of squeezing more miles and battery, man, dog, even the Master Pro had to plug in. Even though Echo had about, I think, 3 bars on his wheel when we got back, he still had to plug in, and as long as everybody else had to plug in. So that kind of like hit me in the head, was like, you know, maybe you don't need a wheel that has 3600 watt hour. What you really, really need more than anything is having a fast charger, because no matter what, no matter where we go, we always plug in somewhere, you know. And I think having a fast charger, especially for how long we chilled at the camp, if I had a fast charger, I would have been right back up to 100% really fast, you know. So I did come home and I started looking at fast chargers for my EXN. Unfortunately, I do have a fast charger, but it's for the MSX and it will not work on the EXN. I really wish it would, because, you know, I mean, fast chargers aren't that expensive, but it's just like I already kind of have one in the house. So it would be nice to have one for the EXN. But luckily, Darren was nice enough to let me use his charger for his commander. So I got to get 6 amps of charging time for a little bit. Not too long, but long enough that, you know, I was at least made it back to the gas station where we ended up calling it quits. But yeah, so I really started looking into getting a fast charger at this point, because I think that's really what it comes down to. The EXN performed beautifully. The speed was there. Everything was there. I got to squeeze a lot out of it. Unfortunately, I didn't get the speed runs on camera, because the first leg of the trip, like the first 30 miles of the trip, I didn't even bring my camera out because I didn't want to. One, I just wanted to ride and kind of escape and kind of just, you know, put myself into the ride, you know, without having to, you know, let me hold a camera and let me get good angles and all this nonsense. So that's what I did. And when I finally whipped my camera out, man, we were already getting down, you know. But with 100% battery when we first started riding, I was zooming, and that's how I ended up hitting 42 miles an hour. Didn't even feel it, didn't know. There was one point when I was riding and I was like, damn, I'm going pretty fast, but I still thought I was like maybe like 38, 39 miles an hour. But as you can see on this bike path, it wasn't very populated. So there were times where we got to Gleam the Q. We were going for it. And, you know, riding next to Echo, and that's my guy, you know, riding next to him, he makes you ride fast, because, you know, the way he just takes off with that Master Pro, I'm like, hey, I want to catch up, you know. So that's what we did, man. But shout out to everybody, man. This was a fantastic ride. The Electric City Riders, these guys are the best. I will put some of the pictures that we took and whatnot. This was an incredible fun ride. And like I said, I needed it more than anything, way more than you guys ever know. So thank you guys for that, for sure. But, you know, to wrap these things up here, I was like, man, you know, when we took our group picture, we all had our EUCs lined up. And I was like, oh, I have the smallest wheel here. I mean, Darren has the commander, and that's not necessarily a large wheel. But, you know, just looking at the picture afterwards, I'm like, oh, I have a baby wheel. So I'm like, man, I mean, granted, like, I don't, this is not the time to upgrade. I have too many things going on in my life to buy a new wheel, you know. But it would be nice. It would be nice just to get a nice, a larger wheel that you know, kind of like commands the attention when we take these groups. I know it's very silly. It's just, you know, a wheel is a wheel. As long as it performs. But man, I would just like to have, you know, something a little more stylish. But the EXN, that's been my baby. That's been taking care of me. So I'm not, in no way am I, you know, throwing the EXN out, you know, on his ass, because it's not big enough wheel. But it's just like, man, it would be nice if I could, you know, grab something, you know. Like I said, I was looking at the Master Pro and stuff like that. But I don't know. After this group ride, I'm not sure if, you know, if I actually want a Master Pro, you know. Like, now I want all the features of the Master Pro, the battery size, the range, the speed. I want all that. But I just feel like it may not just be the perfect wheel for me, as far as just, you know, the look of it, the you know, it's a very heavy, bulky, wide wheel, you know. So that may not be the wheel for me. But there's a bunch of wheels out right now, and you know, I can look. My thing is, I just do not want to go to a smaller wheel. Like, I know the ET Max is all the rage right now, and a lot of other wheels are all the rage. But most of these wheels have smaller tires than or rims than I have right now currently. And that's the one thing I definitely said I will not do is go back to a smaller wheel. If I want to go back to a smaller wheel, I'll whip out the Tesla. You know what I'm saying? Like, if I wanted something, you know, I could just throw around or you know, to that degree. Granted, the Tesla doesn't have suspension on it or the other features of an ET Max, but I'm noticing a lot of these wheels now, the battery capacity is going down. It's not going up, you know? And I understand, you know, to go up it, you need more size. It's going to make a heavier wheel and whatnot. But, you know, if we're not getting more range out of those wheels and we're just getting smaller tires and more agile wheels, I'll chill. I'm good. I'm good on all that. Yeah, man, like I said, this was a phenomenal ride. I learned so much about my wheel, how much pain I can handle in my calves, why I'm getting those pains in my calves, and I was so comfortable sitting, dog. I have my feet hanging off the front of the pedals, which is kind of dangerous too, because it lengthens the amount of braking time you have. There were a few times where we had to stop short, you know, and it was kind of hard for me to get that braking down, but it was still super, it was needed. If I wasn't riding like that, if I didn't get to put my legs out like that and kind of relax my calves, I would have to just like stop. But here, what you're watching right now, it's us at Darren's camp, and like I said, dog, this was so much. It was like an adventure. It's like going to amusement park without the amusements and the park. Well, no, minus the park, we had the amusements. We were having a good time. But yeah, man, I just want to come on here and get this video out. Obviously, that's why I haven't been putting out, you know, content. There was just so much going on in my life, and I just was not in the right headspace to do anything. But yeah, man, I'm just gonna end the video here and let the audio rock out, man. And I will see you guys in the next one, man. Hopefully I have some more entertaining content coming up down the road. All right, thanks for rocking with me, man. I'll see y'all soon. Peace.
They're like basically 500.
I was thinking like maybe 2-3 on the end.
Nah, the one that James has is 300.
See, I'm
me and Flip
that.
Got the $500 one.
Yep.
Nah, you got that.
That's why we put it away a lot.
Yep. No, fucking right.
Yep. Makes sense.
You notice how ours doesn't look like his, right?